It's recording, good. My name is Mike, this is Mike's Tech Channel. I had made this video about three different times. Each time I've had problems with either audio of some sort, like just the sound. So in this case, let's hope the fourth try is the lucky one, and we'll see what happens. Anyway, we're going to dive into the software. Well, the software, the OS on this here, the Atari VCS. I played with it a few times, and to be honest, I don't know what it's doing. It's just weird. It is weird. I'm not going to say anything about it. It's got like this side where you can load an OS, like Ubuntu or Windows. Then it's got this other side, which is for all the games. And then kind of right in the middle is a store. Not even right in the middle. There's a store where they want you to spend money to buy stuff. So it's just kind of awkward. I don't think it's worth $400. I'm sorry to the company that set this up. But from what I understand, it's not Atari. It's like a third-party company that bought the rights to Atari. So the hardware is not bad. Like, it has that Ryzen processor in there. 8 gigs of RAM is about the minimum I'd want to go. I think this would be better with 16 gig, which you can add to it. I mean, it also has that NVMe slot, so you can add more hard drive space to it. It's a nice little hard, like nice compact design. I wish that there was either another HDMI cable so you could run it two outputs, or maybe even something where you could actually put a video card in here. Like if they made it a bit bigger and had it a little taller so you could slide a video card in with like the slots over here, like a daughter board or something, that might work too. Because it's a really nice little machine. And if it was just a PC, then that'd be great too. Or if it was just a case. If this is just a case and I could put like a Raspberry Pi in there, thumbs up. I'd probably pay $50. Well, I'd probably pay $100 just for the case. Canadian, not US. Anyway, let's plug it in and let's hop into the OS. HDMI. This huge cheap Chinese knockoff power brick. This is horrible, by the way. Horrible. Okay, I'm going to set OBS up on the computer, because what I do is I use this USB capture card, like this guy. Shit's just falling everywhere. OBS is over here. Power. Okay, I press the power on the Atari. I'm just waiting now for the screen to pop up here. So there's the Atari symbol. Kind of pixelated too. Yeah, that was Linux. Top left of the screen. Asteroids are my favorite games of all time. Atari logo. Connect your device via Bluetooth or USB cable to start using. Okay, so power's on. You can see the lights down here. Question is, do I hold this or do I just tap it once more? Press and hold. I think we'll turn it off. I think that's off. Press and hold. We'll turn it on. Tap once. Tapping our button, maybe. Waiting patiently for this to connect. The Bluetooth is flashing on the screen. This is just flashing. I have to press it a couple times. Because if I press and hold it, it turns it off. How long do I have to press and hold it for? Oh my god. This, see right here? I'm done with this thing. So I'm pressing and holding. Look at that, it's been like a minute, and it's still not connected. Is it connected? I don't know. Okay. Took long enough, holy crap. I'm seriously done with this. I'm selling this thing, it's not worth keeping. Okay, so there's the controller, just popped up on the screen. Main menu, all this crap, select. I do like the... And I swear to God, we've gone through all this before. Why is it asking me to do it again? Why can't it just memorize the settings and stay there? All right, now, audio, I hope it's capturing the audio from here. Okay, VCS account. I don't need an account, so I'm just going to choose guest. Fancy graphics. Okay, so here's the main screen. This is called the Atari Vault. At the top, we have home, games, apps, store, and system. So I'm going to go up to the top to system. And then way to the right, I see guest and time. So into system. So here on the top, we have account, general settings, network, devices, storage. On the left, we have edit account, remove account, and legal. Let's see what legal looks like. I would like information. Nope. Send me info. Nope. Do this, do that, now that. Okay. Remove account. No accounts to remove. Edit account. No edits. No accounts to edit. So the top. Okay. We'll go over to storage. This is just going to show the one hard drive. So I don't want to create a new account or sign in. 5% used, 20, okay, that's a 32 gig drive in there. I don't even know where my mouse is now. Devices, just this. Wireless, my devices, pair new controllers or update controllers. You can't update the controllers. I went through all this yesterday, but you'll never know because the audio was crap. Okay, network, it's on my Wi-Fi network. You can see all the other Wi-Fi networks. Ethernet. Holy crap, this is so laggy. All right, general settings. We have display, preferences, control, system updates, and factory reset. Under display, we have two options for resolution, 1920 by 1080 or 3840 by 2160, which is a 4K. I'm not going into 4K because this is like a 1440 monitor. Preferences, we have the VCS name, sleep time, language. Controls, we are using right now the modern controller. System updates, I'm not going to go into this because pain in the ass. And factory reset, there's nothing for me to reset. Okay, so that was general settings, account, well, there's nothing to do in the account. Okay, so I'm going to go into store. Now, here's what they would like you to spend money. This comes with the Atari VCS One Vault. So I can filter by games. You can see like 25 bucks is a little pricey. Ant Stream Arcade, I don't know what that is. Thrustlander, 15 bucks. Plex is free. Spearmaster is 10. Netflix is free, I'd hope so. Disney Plus. So Vault 2, 5 bucks. I clicked on it. Let's go into Vault 2 and take a look. And when I look at this, let's take a look at the trailer maybe really quick. Is the audio recording on this? I don't know. Yar's Revenge. These are all games we have. Back. We have those games. Okay, so more games. Something Ate My Aliens, 16 bucks. Super Smash. Super Mash. Don't mess Super Smash with Super Mash. Where are we here? Super Mash, $19. I did click on it, didn't I? In Super Mash, you're an independent video game store clerk who's found a magical game console that spews out unlimited retro games. That would actually be kind of fun. If we can see the screenshots. Screenshots, screenshots. There's one. Cool looking. Apps. Okay, so that's your store. Plex, Twitch, Disney Plus, Twitch, Hulu, HBO, Prime, YouTube. VCS Companion, that's your phone. PC mode. Okay, well, we're not going to worry about that either. Apps. Installed apps. Nothing. Games would be installed games, which is just the vault that this comes with, which is also the same thing you're going to find under home. So when I go to home, it would put all your apps and everything there. So when I click on the VCS vault, let's dive into it here. sound, logo, white screen, Code Mystics. All right. So here's our vault. See, it's funny, this is staying where it left off. Okay, so here, on the, if I use the right mouse button, it will move the cabinet around. See how it's spinning it? Left control will then switch over between the games. So there's Missile Command, Millipede, Major Havoc, I like that game. Lunar Lander, difficult. Liberator, never played it. Gravatar, Crystal Castles, Centipede, Black Widow, Asteroids Deluxe, Asteroids, Warlords, Tempest, Breakout, Sprint, Space Duel, Red Baron, which is a classic, and back to Pong. Okay, so each one of those is an arcade cabinet. And some of them are kind of confusing. So if I go into Sprint, let's say Sprint 1 or Sprint 2. I'm going to try and drive one. So I think I'm playing. Is that my game? It's difficult. I don't know what I'm doing. And we're done. Okay, now when you press the X, that takes you down to the joystick. So we were at the cabinet, now we're at the joystick. And once again, this is going to do the same thing. The right button here will move the screen back and forth, the screen of the box. And then you'll see all the games here. So Starship and Star Raiders, classic. Sprint Master, Space War, Slot Racers, Slot Machines, Skydiver, Sentinel, Secret Quest, Save Mary, Haunted House, Return to Haunted House, sorry, Volleyball, couple sports. Radar Lock, Race, Quad Run, never even heard of that. Pong Sports, Outlaw, I played Outlaw quite a bit on my Atari 2600. Off the Wall, Night Driver, Missile Command, Golf, Millipede, Maze Craze, Human Cannonball, Home Run, that could be a few games actually. Is it just baseball? So disappointed that E.T.'s not on here. Okay, Haunted House, Hangman, Gravatar, Golf, Football, Flag Capture. What's funny, the artwork on these are beautiful. The games are horrible. I would love, though, to see a coffee table book of just the artwork. Fatal Run, Double Dunk, Dodge 'em. Desert Falcon, never played it. Demons to Diamonds, never played that either. Crystal Castles, heard about it, never played it. Combat 2, Combat with Tank. Codebreaker, never played it. Circus Atari. 54 games for Championship Soccer. Centipede. Casino. Canyon Bomber. I like to think the casino wouldn't be a hard game to make. And Touch Me, brain game. Brain game called Touch Me. Bowling, Blackjack, Basketball, Basic Math, that would be interesting as well, I bet. Atari Video Cube, Asteroids, Air Sea Battle, Adventure, one of the best, of course. Still kind of complicated, though. Concentration, 3D Tic-Tac-Toe, Yar's Revenge, a classic. Warlords, didn't they make three Warlords? Pinball, Chess, Checkers, Tempest, Sword Quest they made three of. Waterworld, Sword Quest. Fireworld, Sword Quest, Earthworld. Okay, there we are. That's basically it. I mean, Submarine Commander, Stunt Cycle, Street Racer, Stellar Track, Strategic Space Combat Game. Doesn't that not look... That sounds fascinating. So let's click on it. Choose an option by pressing up or down. Okay, well, I'm not going to pick that. I just want to play. Starfleet to Starship Commander, your mission is to destroy 9 alien warships in 16 stardates. Command, galaxy map is flashing. Pick a quadrant. Galaxy map. How do I move around? I don't know. Warp, sure. course, sure, factor. What am I doing? Stardate 9, Aliens 9, Energy, Photons, Launcher, Phasers, Engines, Short Range Scan, Long Range Scan, Quadrant Sector. Sure, sure. Am I not already there? What am I doing? Anyway, boring, moving on. Okay, we'll get out of there. Okay, that is that. That, seriously, I'm done with this. Press X again. This takes us into the list view. So you can switch between. Here you can see, for example, action games. I'm really surprised that Pitfall is not in there. And you can just pick one off the wall, for example. Switch between. Okay, I'm pressing A. One player. Am I playing? I don't know. Am I moving? Okay, this is the D-pad. Apparently I'm trying to catch those things or not catch those things. Do I want them or do I not want them? If I try dodging them, will I live? Nope, apparently nope. If you dodge them, you die. So I guess I gotta catch them. Or bounce them back up. This is like breakout, I guess. And I died. Last man standing. If that's a man. Last alien standing. Okay, I'm done. Done. And there we have it. How do I get back to the main menu now? X. Okay, how do I get back to the main menu? List button. Nope. I don't want to go in there. How do I get out of this button? Back. Do I quit the game? Yes. Alright, where's the off button, by the way? I thought there was a way of powering this thing down. Oh, there it is. Yeah, so when you're in system, and you're trying to, oh my god, it's like, just get out of here. Power. Okay, cancel sleep, restart, turn off. You know what, I'm going to do a quick reset of this thing first, if I can. Factory reset. Removes all profiles and settings, but keeps, removes, and I, well. We'll do a quick factory reset. Select account. I'm not selecting the account. If I can't do a reset, then this is just, do I have to be logged in to do a reset? Because this is horrible. All right, 15 minutes. That's enough. Okay, so that was that. Now, I don't think the VCS is worth the money. I have one of these. This is called a Atari Flashback. And you know what? These are literally $10. You go to the thrift store, 10 bucks. I'll see them at Walmart sometimes for 39 bucks. This has a bunch of Atari video games in it if you really want that retro game. If you want something that plays games and is a computer at the same time, I would recommend the C64 Mini because the new firmware update lets you plug in USB sticks, which you can load the games onto. This is hands down one of my favorite toys. Seriously, I paid 40 bucks for this thing, Canadian. And yeah, it looks like a toy because it is a toy. And in reality, it's just a little, what's like a Raspberry Pi. I can pull all this apart and build a little Raspberry Pi. Speaking of Raspberry Pis, the Raspberry Pi that I have, my Retro Pi, plays all of the games I needed to play, which are like cabinets, like coin ops. So if I want Asteroids, I'll play it on there. This is not worth 400 bucks or whatever it is they're asking. I'm lucky that I sold this and I'm dropping it off tomorrow. And I don't think I'm going to get stuck with it, but man, I would not buy it for that price. $199, great deal. The US $199, have to think twice about it. But man, it is it's just confusing right now. It's just a confusing thing. Anyway, that's all I have to say. If you like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up. And if you don't, leave a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. The bell is over here. Keep in touch. Let's talk soon. Tell me what's shaking. What's going on? If you have any comments, leave them down below. Thanks for watching. Okay, so OBS is on. I'm in HDMI record. I'm going to only record the audio from this guy. And you are getting the audio here separately. So hopefully, I pray to God, the audio is okay on this. All right, let me stop it now. I'm going to change the battery and shit anyway.